Hello, everyone. This is Rick with Cybermedics, and today we're going to add a Gmail account to our iPhone using one of seven different methods. So what I want to do is step you through each of these for transferring an existing account onto your iPhone. Go to google.com just to show you the verification methods that are on this account. We'll click security. We'll come down here to two-step verification. It'll ask us to sign in. We'll use our password manager, Control Shift L, to autofill the account. So we have a link to Bitwarden security videos for password management above. And if you don't trust a vault for some reason, even though this can be locked down with multiple methods, you can also use double-blind passwords that we also have a link to the video above. So click next. Methods. We're going to walk through each of those as a way to add this account over here onto the iPhone. So go to your iOS store and download the Gmail account. Launch the application. Once you've launched the application, you're going to go into the settings and say add another account. So this is the account that's already on there, and this is the account that we want to transfer onto the phone. So we'll say add another account, select Google, press continue, enter the email address, add your password, and the first method that comes up is security key. So on the security keys, this is physically what they look like. It's one of the most secure methods for protecting your accounts. This one is an NFC key. They also make them where they plug directly into the port of your device using the Lightning or USB-C, or they can plug into your computer using a USB-A, as pictured here. The easiest way to add them to your iPhone is to use NFC. You would place the key in this location, and as soon as you place the key, what would happen is, after you selected that method, it would automatically add the account. So this account would be added onto the phone. So we'll move on to the next method. Try another way. Next method we'll select for adding a Gmail account is get a one-time security code. What this does is allow you to use another Apple device where maybe you have logged into the account. If you have another Apple device, you can download this Google Smart Lock. Once you've downloaded that on your other Apple device that's already authenticated to this account, you can say generate a security code. Once you click that, you'll get a security code. That code would be entered into the box here, and then that account would automatically be transferred onto the new device. We'll select try another way. Next, we'll click here where it says tap yes on your phone or tablet. We'll call up that device. As you can see, it's listed over here as under Google Prompts, Galaxy A52. What happens when you click that, you just say yes here, and it would automatically bring this account over onto your iPhone. So we'll cancel out of this and go on to the next method. Next, we'll select the method of use your phone or tablet to get a security code, even if it's offline. And follow the steps here. Just go to settings on the app and then tap Google. So we'll click Google here under settings. Manage your Google account. Go to security. Under security, there's something called security code. You click the security code, and due to security policy, it will not display this on the phone, but those codes will be similar to this, and they're good for approximately 15 minutes. You would enter that code in this box, and that would add the account to your iPhone. So we'll move on to the next method. Get a verification code under Google Authentication App. It doesn't have to be Google Authentication App. You can use any authentication app. I don't recommend Google. I recommend Microsoft Authenticator. We'll bring the authentication app up on the Galaxy phone. And the main reason I like the authentication app on Microsoft Authenticator as opposed to Google's is because when you open it, it's going to make you re-authenticate to the phone. So if someone was able to get a hold of your phone and the phone was open for some reason, they still couldn't get into authentication app without authenticating back to the phone. So for this account over here that we're adding, this is the code, and they're good for 30 seconds and then they reset. That code would be put in here and then the account would be added to the Apple device. The next method we will use is get a verification code sent to a telephone number. And that code would be entered here. However, this phone number, which is a Google Voice number, it's not a cell phone number. And you can get a Google Voice number by going to voicegoogle.com and signing up for one. You have to have a cell phone account in the US to link it, but then you can de-link your cell phone. Don't recommend having cell phones used for any type of authentication method for two reasons. One, the SMS messages are sent in the clear, can be intercepted. And two, the phones can be hijacked and someone can steal that cell phone number. If you have a Google Voice number locked down with authentication methods, little chance that someone can commandeer that phone number. We'll bring up the Google Voice application on the phone that is already authenticated to this account. And you can see the code is here. You would just take this code and enter it in this box, and that would authenticate the account. We'll go to the last method, and that is backup codes. When you add second factor authentication to your Gmail account, you will get 10 single-use codes that can be used either for account recovery or for adding that account to another device. Having gone through all of those methods for adding an account and walking through the security for each one of those, which one do we recommend? The method I strongly recommend is using a security key. These keys are practically unhackable. Every other method here possibly could be hacked more easily than the security key. That key can be used through the NFC. It can be used to plug into the device. And ultimately, adding it to your iPhone is a simple process of using the NFC. Once the device is authenticated with the key, you can take the key and put it in a safe deposit box and you're safe. And you don't need the key again unless you get a new device. If you've lost your device and you have access to the key, you'll always be able to re-authenticate to your accounts. This concludes our video demonstration of adding a Gmail account to your iPhone using one of seven different authentication methods. Hope you will press that like button and subscribe to the channel. This supports our efforts in helping others with technology, and have a great and wonderful automation day.